Observe the great magician, the mighty wizard. See his pointy hat. Behold his mighty staff, his magic wand, his long flowing robes. Far too impractical to do farming work in. This is a man of the gods. A man full of knowledge of the ancients. Can you not see his long white beard? This is a wise old man. Wise in the words of the ancients. He can read. He has words, magic words, written in his spellbook. The spellbook he keeps in his private book-lined study with his candlesticks and incense. These are the magic words of the ancients, who lived in the age of magic, in the land of magic, far to the east. The land of the Magi. The land of Zarathustra, who also did the spake. The wisdom of the ancients, can't you hear him chant magical incantations in dead languages? This is no ordinary man. He has status. He has finery and wealth. But he does not waste his time with luxuries. He keeps himself to himself and his fellow wizards, away from the world of women and the activities of agriculture and commerce. Behold his pointy hat, his long robes, his staff, his magical amulet on a long chain. This man is clearly a great wizard. He knows the wisdom of the ancients. Bow down and kiss his magic ring. Lo, he is offering you a drink from his magical goblet. Draw near to his table, festooned with candlesticks and the scent of fine perfumes from the east, the magical holy lands, which block from his nostrils the stench of the sweat of honest toil of the flock he fleeces regularly each week, and especially at harvest, which he blesses with his magic words and hand gestures. Look, he has the symbol of his role as a pastor, a keeper of sheep, the crook, with which he can reach out beyond his natural reach to grasp the wayward member of his flock with his golden crook, like any poor hard-working shepherd would carry, a golden crook bedecked with jewels. 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 See his magnificent white beard. This is a man who wears his great age well. He has not been broken and fatigued by hard work. His has been a life of piety, study and contemplation, not graft and sweat like a farm horse. He is a great man. He has great learning, which he keeps to himself like the precious gift from the gods it is. He can read. He can write. He has been to university. He has been taught how to think and how to stop others from doing the same and usurping his special place as the holy man, the great and mighty wizard.